Hello everyone, today we do experiment 4, which is the interference and diffraction of light. We have two parts, which are single-slit diffraction and double-slit interference. To do this experiment, we have different kinds of components. The first component is the laser, and the second component, as you see, is the slit, which we put a single slit here, and the final part is the light sensor. To do this experiment, we have to move light sensor, and finally we give a graph, which is the light intensity as a function of position, and you can find the values of A, as you see here. The values of A, which we have to find the A, and the experimental value of the A is equals to this value, and we find A from this formula and compare these experimental values. To do this, we have a formula in which their values can be seen from the right hand side, and the graph will be like this. And if you find theta from this geometric relation, you can find the values of A, and finally, of course, as I said, you have to compare the value of A with the experimental one. We can push the start button, and then we have to move light sensor. So finally we get a light intensity versus position graph. As you see, we have a single slit diffraction peak. I have to adjust their values like this. We have a single slit diffraction peak. You can find theta values from here and the center of the peak and the tail of the peak, which is measured from these lines, and then you can find theta values, and then you have to calculate the values of A and compare this value with the experimental one. Second part is the double slit interference. We have two different slit in this part. Their separation will be given by D, and their width is the A. As you see, double slit interference different from the single one. There is too many peaks in the graph will be. As we will see, and the values of theta can be found followed from the m values of these peaks from this formula. The values of the different parameters, as I see you, given on the right hand side. Similarly, you have to find D values from this formula for a single peak from here, and compare d values, theoretical d values, with the experimental one. To start, I push the start button and then we obtain a graph, the same graph with the single slit diffraction, and we change the slit with a double slit and press the button and move the light sensor to the right. We find too many peaks in the double slit interference, but their envelope is the same with the single slit diffraction. You can find the theta value from the central peak by calculating the distance with other peaks, and then you can find theta, and then you can find d values. Of course, you have to compare the calculated value of d with the experimental one.